it seemed to be a Western concept altogether, but we are now concerned about it in India. When and how did this happen?
Well, we realized the importance of the concept of integrated reporting, at least with the introduction of what we call the business responsibility reporting, in short BRR. It was done in in 2012 by SEBI, which wide a circular dated August 13th mandated inclusion of business responsibility report as a part of the annual report for 100 top listed entities. The said reporting requirement was in line with the national voluntary guidelines on social, environmental and economic responsibilities of businesses. Now, in short, it is called the NVG guidelines. Now, this NVG guidelines was notified by the Ministry of Corporate Affairs way back in 2011 July, even though the ministry had actually come out with such a notification and laid the foundation stone in 2011. But because it was voluntary, not much response or attention was laid on it. But when you know SEBI made it mandatory, it seemed that India Inc. had to wake up. Later on, the corporate social responsibility or CSR as we know it, reporting scheme came in with the provision of section 135 and schedule 7 of Companies Act 2013. The baseline of BRR was of adopting responsible business practices by a listed company as they accessed funds from the public. So, the elementary question was they also have some kind of interest getting involved for which they are obligated to make an exhaustive disclosure on a regular basis to the public.
Great. We know why IR came in it objectives. Can you now explain the basic elements of IR?
See, IR is based on six C's. C stands for capital. Now, first is financial, manufactured, followed by intellectual, then human, fifth is social, and last is natural. What they do? They together recognize the concepts in an organization and they also take into account various factors on which the entity is dependent on. So, it is important that all such forms of capitals are disclosed to the shareholders to take an informed decision about investments like we discussed earlier.
So, what does each capital talk about?
The contents of the six capitals can be summarized as follows. They only speak of the general character of each of the category, but not of the specific items in each category. However, one should understand what items need to be identified in each of the category. For example, in financial capital, the cash generated from operations, bank loans, deposits from shareholders are crucial. In manufactured capital, land, building, infrastructure is important. Environmental certifications also find relevance. In intellectual capital, on the other hand, it focuses on R&D expenditure, patents, internal development of software, licenses, etc. Whereas, when we talk of human capital, it takes into account the accounting hours put in by the labor, capacity building measures, and yes, most important, salary. Lastly, when we talk of the social capital, it emphasizes on investments being made in skill development and socio-economic development.
Then how does IR make business more responsible?
Good question. So, IR is a process of understanding the link between financial results and sustainability impacts, which is vital for business managers, which is connected to both short and long term success. The core of IR is providing much more richer information and measurements based on which better decisions can be made. I will give you a basic example. Say for instance, a bank in your city has been financing your borrowing needs over a period of time without charging any processing fees. Apparently, this will certify your strength in the market, for which the banker is doing you a favor. But what if the actual fact is that the bank has no large ticket borrower and its monthly loan disbursement target gets fulfilled by lending funds to you? Further, the cost of advocacy for bank loan to other customers is much higher than doing away with the processing fees. Well, IR will bring out these kind of facts. It matches the processes with the figures. It is first concerned about why and then focuses on how and then prescribes what is to be done.
Can IR prevent frauds?
This is a favorite question of mine, I'll say. Well, in my opinion, IR is like blockchain technology. Sounds strange. Let me explain. Well, blockchain is defined as an incorruptible digital ledger of transactions that can be programmed to record virtually everything of value. Let me explain. Say you have an Excel file wherein you have a main page and then you have inserted various pages. Every time you make a change in a sub page, the change will reflect on the main page and the main page will get affected. So, any change in any of the cells with change in a figure will make a change in the main Excel file. So, blockchain also operates this way. How does it apply to IR? Well, IR is a very closed function of six capitals like we discussed. So, if you do any kind of fudging in any of the capitals, it will affect on the main page or the main integrated reporting. Hence, it is more like a blockchain. The moment you change a figure in any remote cell, it is reflected on the main page. So, frauds, in my opinion, when you are following IR, will be minimized.
The things that given that IR wants to report changes in six capitals, how are we supposed to know what aspects of each capital need to be analyzed? Are there any guiding principles?
Yes, IR has seven guiding principles based on which the information needs to be presented. Strategic focus and future orientation, connectivity of information, stakeholders' relationship, materiality, conciseness, reliability and completeness, consistency and comparability. The beauty of this system is that all the above are self-explanatory and easily understood. The IIRC has still given some directions about each of them.
Can we now understand how an IR report actually looks like?
Definitely. For that, we will have to look at, say, Mahindra Mahindra's annual report of 2017 and 18, and I will take you from pages 18 to 26 onwards to give you a fair view. So, let us see. If you look at the report gives you a lot of data in some pages only. Now, if you wanted to trace the data in case of a conventional reporting, I am sure it will take ages for you to find out.
I thought that under IR, the total annual report will be in not more than 50 pages, but we still have a 300 pages document. Why so?
Now, this is a question which everybody asks me. See, this is because IR for Indian entities is still experimental and all other aspects of conventional reporting still stay, like the sustainability reporting, corporate governance report, the management discussion and analysis report. So, IR is not the ultimate report as of now. It is only a way of presenting information.
So, what exactly is the scenario currently in India for IR?
Well, as I said, in India, IR is in still the experimental stage. I will be more specific. SEBI in 2017 encouraged top 100 listed companies, then it expanded it to 500 listed companies to go for voluntary adoption from 17-18 of the BRR framework, like we discussed earlier, the BRR business responsibility framework. So, the information regarding integrated reporting may be provided in any of the three ways, which is given in the circular of 2017. Number one, separately as a report, or by integrating the information of IR in the management discussion and analysis report, or thirdly, by preparing a separate annual report based on the IR framework. So, we have three options. So, the day the third option, that is creating an annual report totally based on the IR framework, is actually done, all other reports like CG, MD&A, CSR will be dissolved and we will have a true integrated reporting regime. Well, now actually it's a hybrid regime in India, and that's the reason even though we talk of integrated reporting, you still have that 300 page document.
I think it's quite a problem than a solution, right?
I'll say these are teething problems. The issue is with the mindset. See, there are two components in IR, a business model and sustainability initiatives. While all businesses in India have a very strong business model, but the fact is that much smaller percentage report on the documentary side of sustainability initiatives. Hence, there is a gap that needs to be fulfilled. One is the business aspect and the sustainability aspect. Once we consciously map the sustainability initiatives, then I am sure many reports will go away and the IR will serve its true purpose for which it is intended without making it a extra burden as it is today.
Sir, after the so many questions, I have just one last question. With Make in India in everything, do we have a Made in India IR?
Yes, we have a Made in India version of IR also, and it is called the National Guidelines on Economic, Social and Environmental Responsibilities of Businesses 2018. You will find this on the ministry's website, and it is a more advanced version of the NVG guidelines that was done in 2011.
So, thank you so much for having the interesting discussion with us on integrated reporting. Thank you so much.